We are under the lights this evening as we get you set for another edition of Baseball on the Show. Coming up, we've got a good matchup in store between the Los Angeles Angels of Anaheim and the Philadelphia Phillies. It's Phillies Baseball next on the show. Zach Wheeler gets the starting assignment for the Phillies. And please, Zach, what do you got?
One of the things we'll look for early, Matty, Zach Wheeler, at times control can be an issue. So one of the keys for Zach Wheeler, getting ahead early in counts.
Into the box is the leadoff hitter Cameron Maybin, and we are ready for baseball.
Leading off tonight for the Angels, the right fielder.
Here comes Cameron. The first pitch.
Maybin.
Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact. These Phillies, as they enter play here tonight, fellas, they've been playing better than 500 baseball of late, 5-3 in their last 8 games.
Yeah, Matty, for me today, the key to winning this ball game begins and ends on the mound. And it has to be early on the attack, getting 0-1. Can't allow these guys to get into count leverage and to hunt your fastball. There has to be execution down and away, up and in to keep these guys honest, and it has to start from pitch one.
That misses, and we're even at 2-2.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Good job going down and hanging with it that time. Another 2-2 offering. Hard hit ball to second. And he will pass it over to in time for the out.
Got it, cut. The left fielder, Ryan Goodman.
So striding in, Brian Goodwin. First offering on its way. And a bit too high with that one. It's 1-0. Time for a look at our umpires in this one. Behind the plate is Ed Drummond.
Yeah, Matty, hey, you know what, Bureau? This Ed Drummond, he's a good umpire. Fair umpire, good ball and strike umpire. Pretty much straight down the road.
That's all you look for, Dan. Just be consistent. I don't care if you're given 2 to 3 inches off the outside corner, but you can't do it on the inside corner. If you're going to stick to one thing and stay consistent with it, no player will have a break.
The cover field number 27.
Stepping in, Mike Trout. What a season he's having. Entering play, leading the league in 2 of the 3 Triple Crown categories.
Yeah, he's just off the league leading the batting race. He's in the top 5 in that category, but he is out in front in home runs and ribbies, so we'll see if he can make a push for the Triple Crown.
And the pitch. And that's in there for strike one. And he falls behind 0-2. Nothing in 2 count and the pitch. And he fouls this one off. 2 out, nobody on. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Angels go down 1-2-3. So now the Phillies offense will see what they can do. No score. Shohei Ohtani, the right-hander from Japan, will get the start. starting assignment in this one. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, so far this year, this guy hasn't pitched very well on the road. He's actually struggled on the road, so it'll be interesting to see if he can turn that around here in this one.
And that'll bring up Gene Segura. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Here's the pitch. So, fellas, this Angels team entering play here tonight. Fair to say they're not playing their best baseball right now. Losers of five of their last six.
All right, Matty, they show up for game one of this road trip. They have to find a way to play a little bit better baseball. Coming off a recent homestand where they were only able to squeak out three wins. But at the end of the day, the way this team's been playing, three wins is a significant positive. So let's see how game one of this road trip treats them.
Lined up and the 0-2 pitch.
One ball, two strikes. Nope, at the ball.
Fastball swung on and missed for the first out.
I really liked it. He gave up nibbling out of the zone trying to get the chase. That wasn't working, so he just reached back and fired a good old country hardball fastball right by him. No better feeling in the world when you're a pitcher than throwing a fastball right by a guy.
Into the box, Justin Turner. As he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. He'll enter play here with an average just over 250. 14 homers and 34 driven in. The windup and the 1-0 pitch. Swung on and missed. One and one.
Going to be a long day if he executes like this, punching tickets right out of the gate.
Takes one off the inside corner for ball two. One out, nobody on. And it's fouled away. The 2-2.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball, and the hitter just fouls that one off.
There's a fastball well off the plate inside.
Just missed with that heater, but even if he wanted to swing, I don't think he could have caught up to that one.
Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. Hit out towards second. And the off-balance throw gets him. Nice play for the out.
Batting third, the center fielder, Mark Withenshaw.
Settling in now, Mark Withenshaw. First cuts for him here with the bases open and two away. And the pitch. The fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. Two and oh to the Philly center fielder. Bases are empty here with two men out. Cue shot here out towards short, and this will be pulled in easily for the final out of the inning. Three up, three down for Philadelphia. We are still scoreless. And digging in next will be Anthony Rendon. He'll get us started in the top of the second.
Number six, Anthony Rendon.
First pitch of the at-bat.
Nope. Ball one, no strike.
Out of play off to the right. It's 1-1. Now here's the pitch. Got him swinging on the split finger pitch, and that's out number one.
My man on the mound just got great strikeout stuff working for him these days. Looking back at his last start, he racked up 9 Ks, and now he's looking like he can put up similar numbers in this one.
Here's Didi Gregorius. He swings and grounds it to short, and that finds its way into center for a one-out base hit.
The second baseman, Tommy Rafael.
Here's
Tommy Mostella now, fouled off. Fouled away. Gregorius stands at first with one out. Sent on the ground out to second. And that gets through for a one-out base hit. And they'll have runners at the corners following the one-out single.
You know, they were the old school thinking sometimes is when you're going through a bad streak like this. By any way you can get a little jam shot, even though it wasn't pretty, maybe this could get this guy finally going.
Yeah, I can't tell you how good that had to feel right there. There's moments where you slap that donut off your bat, you don't even want to walk home, but you're scuffing so bad.
In there, 0-1, and there are runners at the corners now. Him up. And he will make the catch back there as they're a step closer to getting out of this with two away now.
The catcher, Jason Castro.
Now at the plate, Jason Castro. And the home away splits tell us he's actually quite a bit better hitting on the road than he is at home. Stretch, here's the pitch. Way behind that pitch, it's 0-1. Castro, California-born ball player. This is his 10th season at the major league level, so almost a decade, which is quite an accomplishment.
Yeah, Matty, you ain't kidding right there. 10 years, we refer to that in the biz as hitting full passion.
1-1 to Jason Castro. Ball and two strikes to the Angels catcher.
I never found myself on the mound in the big leagues, but it must be nice to be able to go to that good hard fastball.
Started the chase there. They'll appeal it down to third, and no swing. It's ball two. No score here as we play inning number two. Struck him out. You talk about pulling a rabbit out of your hat. He gets out of the jam and the side is retired. Angels strand a couple. We go to the bottom of the second. No score. In the National League.
And not surprisingly, he's also near the top of the league in slugging percentage, which means not every ball is near the yard. A lot of extra base hits in this guy's arsenal.
delivery to him on the way.
Nope, outside.
Taken strike one.
You can bet he wants that one back at the plate right now. That's a pitch you normally see a guy drive if he has the right approach going.
That nibbled the corner there but missed 2-1.
Pretty good pitch right here to a left-handed power hitter. The one thing you want to do, keep the ball inside so he can't get those long arms out and extended. Really good pitcher's pitch right there, even though he didn't get the called strike.
3-1 to him. Pulled toward right center field. Trout has a read on it. One out. So the bases are empty with one man gone. And that'll bring in a perennial MVP candidate for years to come, Rhys Hoskins. First offering on its way. Hit hard to the right, but foul. Wind up and the 0-1. Swinging strike, and now it's 0-2.
Every time you go out there to start a game on the mound, you hope to settle in quickly and get into a groove, and he's definitely done that so far in the early going. Looks like he could go pretty deep into this one.
Here comes the 0-2 pitch. And he fouls this one off. High and deep down the left field line. And no one will get this one. Bottom of the second here with no score. A swing and a miss for out number two, and a ball he had no chance of making contact with.
Man, I love watching a pitcher that just rears back and blows smoke by a guy at the letters. It's the ultimate challenge pitch, and for me personally, watching hitters swing and miss, man, that's a sight of beauty.
Here's Jay Bruce now. As with two away, he'll swing and miss at the first pitch. It's 0-1. He'll check in here at 277. 13 home runs and the RBI count at 35.
Come on now, get
it. And now a curveball that bounces up to the plate. It's 1-1. And he pumps the fastball by it here. 1-2 now.
Your eyes light up from the offensive side playing in a hitter's park like this. Have to get the ball up to do some damage. I'm not mad at that take.
Two out, nobody on. That's high for a ball. It's 2-2.
Hey, if you're going to throw a pitch like that to this guy, that's right where you want to miss. Any lower, and he'll probably make you pay for it.
Here now the 2-2. It's laid off and the count runs full. Zach Collins would be next if they can keep this inning alive. Bases are empty here with two men out. Strike three called as he can't get the bat off his shoulders. Side retired. Some of our nation's young minds and future leaders here in attendance. Two complete, still scoreless here on the show. third set to get underway, and that'll bring up the dual threat of Shohei Ohtani. First pitch of the inning is taken low and away for a ball. It's 1-0. Here's the pitch.
That's ball two.
And this guy can hit a little bit too, so you just can't lay one in there 2-0.
And now pitch on the way. And a good comeback fastball there. It's two balls and a strike. Grounded down the third baseline, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. Pitch on the way. Swing and a miss as he starts the third the same way he ended the second, with a punch out, one away.
Well, this lineup obviously doesn't get to see this guy very often because he's over in the other league, and it's really showing. He's pitching really well right now, and I'm sure these hitters are plenty happy they don't have to face him multiple times this year.
Here's Cameron Maben now. The first pitch misses to him. It's ball one. Second appearance here, he grounded out to start the ball game. And he lays off a fastball here that looked pretty good, but it's 2-0.
Well, those were a couple of close pitches right there in the inner part of the zone. Hitters will tell you, pitches in that location are tough to do anything with.
Two balls and a strike to the Angels leadoff hitter.
Two balls, one strike.
Third inning, no score to this point. Oh, a textbook slider there, and he's back at even, 2-2. And this is swung on and missed, his fifth strikeout already, and there are two gone in the inning.
Two up, two down on strikes in this inning. He looks really sharp out there, guys.
Brian Goodwin. As the first pitch here's a bit high, it's ball one. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. That evens it up, 1-1. Goodwin, originally from the Tar Heel state of North Carolina, he was a first round pick back in 2011.
Yeah, Matty, they certainly got it right when they drafted this guy. He has turned himself into an absolute superstar. Everybody knows this guy's name, and kids are buying his jerseys.
Now the 2-1 pitch. He's in there for strike number two. Two out, nobody on. Hit out towards second, taken in by Forsythe. And the off-balance throw is right there for the third out. A high degree of difficulty on that one as the side is retired. Now to the plate, Zach Collins, 7, 8, and 9 to start the home third.
Not much going on offensively so far for these guys. Six up, six down. Let's see if the bottom part of the lineup can get something going.
Well, the home crowd seems a little restless, so I'm sure they'd appreciate it. Delivery to him on the way. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1.
Ball, that's out.
Bounce it to the left side. And that's through for a hit. And he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit.
and that swing looked like self-defense than a real quality swing. But hey, he muscled out there. It was enough to get him safely to second. Those are the kind of hits that would drive you nuts.
Into the box now, Logan Forsythe. And he'll hit with a chance to push across the game's first run.
Yeah, great RBI opportunity here. But at the very least, he needs to find a way to advance that runner to third. Small things like that in a tight game can make a big difference.
He's set. Here it comes.
Counts 1-0.
A runner at second. Nobody out. Popped him up. Gregorius over to his right. One away. Next up will be the Phillies pitcher, Zach Wheeler. And with a runner already in scoring position and one away, he is likely not to be bunting here. First pitch coming. Here it is.
Ball one, no strike.
Pulled high in the air out to right field. Maven is there. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. Gene Segura standing in. 0-for-1 here in the early going. Bottom of inning number three, nothing our score. A ball and a strike to the Phillies leadoff man. Segura behind on a 1-2 count.
Two strikes.
Ready with the 1-2. Got him swinging as he runs the fastball by him to end the inning. Phillies strand one. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. Settle in and kick off the inning. Matt Vasgersian joined by Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac with you in the booth. First pitch of the at bat. Line towards center field. And that's a base hit. A little first pitch swing in there as he's on to kick off the inning. So a base hit for him has him aboard to start out their half of the fourth as we take a look at the league leaderboard in hits. And as you can see, he's up near the top, currently sixth in the AL in that category. In now is Anthony Rendon. First pitch swing, he gets a fly ball to left center. And this is taken in out there by Bruce for the first down.
Back to the Angels, the shortstop, Didi Gregorius.
So now to the plate, Didi Gregorius. First delivery to him on the way.
Ball back there.
Well, if you love pitching and defense, this has been a game for you. Are you happy with that, Dan?
I think this continues for a while, Matt. Both of these pitchers are throwing very well, throwing strikes, having good command of their off-speed pitches. This is going to be one of those low-scoring affairs.
And he has to dive, but he's back in easily. Now, 1-0. Swung on, missed, and that's strike one. Throw over to the bag, and the runner back. Angel shortstop behind in the count at a ball and two strikes.
I just think after seeing both those pitches right there, 96, you have to be on the fastball or you're not going to catch up. If you're sitting off speed, that fastball is going to blow right by you.
And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2.
Well, they threw over there multiple times thinking he was going to try to swipe that bag, so they were onto him, but he just waited it out and took off when he had the chance. Nice job of base running there.
Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. He reaches to foul this one away. Popped him up. Segura is there. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away.
The batter number nine, second baseman, Tommy Rochelle.
Two gone now for the Angels in fourth, and that'll bring in Tommy La Stella to bat next. He's set, and the pitch sent out to straightaway center field into a slide, and he makes a great catch to retire the side. Fine sliding catch here will take us to break. We're back to Friday Night Baseball on the show after this.
Been the case.
First pitch on its way. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. And this misses the outside corner, so it's knotted up at 1-1. Two strikes now.
Borderline pitch right there. But as a low ball hitter, you can live with that as long as the umpire doesn't give him north as well.
Tried to shoot the corner and he missed it. 2-2. And he turns this one around high and deep to center field. He's going to haul this one in on the run as he winds up just shy of the wall for the first out. So with one away, let's punch up the graphic and show you the pitch speed comparison for the two starters here in the fourth inning. And boy, you can see it there. couple of power arms out there as both of these guys are working in the high 90s. Digging in for his second at bat, Mark Withenshaw. Here's the first pitch to him. Not cheated on that swing, but the splitters by him 0-2. Swung on and missed that time, and that'll be out number two.
Boy, that's really disappointing for a guy that has wheels, right? All he wants to do is get on base and take advantage of the strength of his game, which is his speed. But with a strikeout right there, you can't get on first base if you strike out.
Next to dig in will be Bryce Harper. He'll take a look at ball one. Flied out in his first at bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far. Now the 1-0.
Yeah.
Swing and he pops him up. And Rendon will look this one in to retire the side. Phillies down in order through four. Still tied, nothing, nothing. And we're back from Citizens Bank Park in Philadelphia. Let's check in with Heidi Watney.
Matt, I had a chance to discuss the state of the Angels offense with their manager between innings, and he told me he's pretty unhappy with their discipline at the plate in this one. He said their pitch selection has been the main reason for their struggles today, as far too often they've been swinging at pitches outside the strike zone. That's leading to a lot of soft contact and easy outs. So the focus going forward is on shrinking the zone and forcing the opposing pitching to throw more strikes.
Leading off for the
All right, Heidi, thank you.
The first baseman, Mark Canna.
First offering on its way. Way inside with that one. Pretty easy take there. Now the 1-0.
One of the best ways to keep a guy uncomfortable is to pound him inside. They're doing that, and this one caught the zone.
Here's the 1-1 pitch. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Just off the outside that time. Laid off for a ball.
If I'm in the box right now, I'm coming unglued. He is going to throw something over the heart of the plate.
Looking to fade his first walk. Here it comes.
Three ball, two strikes.
And he struck him out.
I'll tell you right now, this guy has a shutout going, and it's been all business. He's not messing around trying to pick at corners. He's being aggressive in the zone, and he's attacking each and every one of these hitters up to this point.
Jason Castro, the catcher, is in. First pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. Comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ball game. And this catches the outside corner, strike one.
Look at the radar gun on that slider. Off speed pitch, 91 miles an hour. That's just pure filth.
No runs, three hits, and no errors to this point for the Angels. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. ball and two strikes from Zach Wheeler.
Two balls, two strikes.
Struck him out as well, so the bottom of the order providing little resistance here, and there are two away.
The
Shohei Ohtani digging in next. He's 0 for 1 thus far. Here's the first pitch to him. Too low, 1-0. And a fastball that's about off the radar screen there. It's 2-0. Shot down the first baseline. And that finds its way through for a base hit. The throw into second. The throw pulls him off the bag.
As we look again at that double here, you can see that he was thinking too right out of the box. Smashed it down the line, and that was some great hustle to beat the throw to second to earn himself a double.
Into the box now, Cameron Maybin. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Pulled the fastball down a little too much there. That's ball one. No runs, four hits, and no errors to this point for the Angels. No contact there, and it's 1-2.
1-2.
One and two. Here it is. And it's fouled away. Here's the 1-2. No offer at the curve that time, and it's knotted up at 2-2.
Wanted to get the front door curveball on the inside corner there, but it backed up a little and stayed off the corner.
The set and the 2-2. Late swing, but he's still able to get a lot of this one out toward deep right field. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra basic. And he'll get in there safely.
Now back.
Well, he was almost out of the inning. The last two batters showed him that you can't lose focus on the mound, even if you get two quick outs. Back-to-back doubles shows you just how quickly things can get away from you.
At the plate, Brian Goodwin, as he rips it on the ground to second. Forsythe has it. This one first in time, and that ends the inning. Angels do get a run in the inning on this RBI double. On to the bottom of the fifth, and the Angels lead it here 1-0. And we're back from Citizens Bank Park in Philadelphia. Let's check in with Heidi Watney.
Matt, I talked with Philadelphia's manager during the break about the Phillies' offensive production to this point, and he was pretty blunt in saying they're just not having very good at-bats. They've only managed one base runner in this game, so it's easy to see why he said they haven't shown much fight today. He's hoping to see someone step up and find a way to get something going, though. This game isn't out of hand, so it remains to be seen if they can snap out of this funk and climb back into this one.
All right, Heidi, thank you. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and next to bat will be the first baseman, Rhys Hoskins. Infield in the overshift here, now the pitch. In there, strike one. Wind up and the 0-1.
Nope, ball one.
There's a fastball well off the plate inside. Now the 2-1 pitch.
Ball three.
Great AB up until this point. A walk right here could really just infuse some confidence into this lineup.
3-1 pitch.
Hey! Walk out. 3-2. Chopper to third. To second for one. On to first, but not in time as he's in there ahead of the throw. So that one wasn't quite as sharply enough to turn two.
Yeah, choppers like that make it really tough. You can't make the ball hit you much faster, so the key is making sure you field it cleanly and at least get one, which they did there.
Riding in once again, Zach Collins. Here comes the first pitch. Runners on first with one down. Grounder down the line at third. But this will be a foul ball as he's behind 0-2 now. Two balls and two strikes to the Phillies catcher.
Boy, that's a tough pitch to lay off right there, just out of the strike zone. But listen, when you're a 300 hitter, you don't chase a lot of those so-called pitcher's pitches. This guy knows the strike zone.
Oh, and he can't catch up to the fastball as he swings and misses for the second out. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as a hitter. You think you can drive it, but it's really hard to get on top of that good high hard fastball.
In now, Logan Forsythe. Oh. Fastball. Whoa, look out. That just about got him in the coconut. So far, 0-for-1 with a flyout. Runs outside, so it goes to 2-0 now.
Well, we all know he's not the greatest threat with the bat up there. His numbers certainly aren't that pretty. But, hey, I give him credit. He's really working the count right here.
3-0 now. Runner on first with two away. There's
ball four.
He did not want to let the hitter off the hook with two outs. And now he's got a runner in scoring position to deal with.
So stepping in, Zach Wheeler. He'll look to bring home that tying run
second with a base hit into the outfield. Trying to hold the lead. Here's the delivery. Ball one. Here's the 1-0. 2-0 now.
Can't fall behind against the pitcher. Need to minimize pitch count against the easy outs, and this is certainly one of them.
And he has a cut at that one, but misses 2-1.
Oh, man, was that a hack. He's trying to create his own run support with a swing like that.
And the 2-1.
Whoa, that's up there.
Well, he really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type of hitter you want to dance around with.
Out of the stretch with 3-1 home. Now fastball swung on and missed, and it's full 3-2.
When you get yourself to a 3-1 count and you get a fastball, those are the ones you really want to punish. Couldn't get the bat on it, so we'll see if that comes back to haunt him.
He struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Phillies leave a couple. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. Top half of the sixth about to get started. That brings up Mike
Trout. The center fielder, number 27, Mike Trout.
First pitch of the at-bat. 1-0. It looked like the fastball got away from him there.
This guy's been throwing the ball great so far, but it's going to be tested here. 4, 5, and 6 coming up this part of the lineup.
The 1-0 home is taken for ball two.
Hey, you want to talk about being in the zone? This guy's been raking lately, and it all starts with his pitch selection. Two great takes, and he's almost daring the pitcher just go ahead and challenge him.
Down low, and the plot thickens here, 3-0. Anthony Rendon waits on deck. 3-0 pitch. He's looked at for the first strike. Four pitches, all takes. He's showing a lot of patience here.
And I like that from a guy like him, Matty. He can do a lot of damage on a base pass with his legs, so there's no reason for him to get overly aggressive if he's not getting anything to handle.
Tough pitch to lay off, but he did, and it's ball four, so the leadoff hitter's aboard to start the
sixth. Rendon.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Anthony Rendon. No hits to this point. Here comes the first pitch. Runners on the move for second. Just able to get a piece of that for strike one. On its way, the 0-1 pitch. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Withenshaw settle under it to make the play for the first out as the runner will have to head back to first.
Next to the Angels, the shortstop, Didi Gregorius.
Digging in once again,
Didi Gregorius.
A hit in two tries so far. Comes set, here's the nothing and nothing pitch. And they pitch out here, but nothing's going on. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. With it is Wheeler. Runner at first here, one man out. And a fastball runs a bit inside. He's down 2-0.
This is why I love having athleticism and speed on your team. You can tell the runner on first base is certainly messing with the mechanics of the pitcher.
3-0 now. As a look, now the pitch. And oh, they won't let him walk that easily, as that somehow ruled a strike. 3-1 now. From the belt, the pitch.
We got 3 balls and 2 strikes.
Runners on first with one down. Popped him up. Segura over to his left. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away.
Now batting, the second baseman, Tommy Lestella.
Coming to the plate now, Tommy Lestella. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. First pitch of the at bat on its way. Pitch out, nothing doing. Two out with the man at first. Hit softly down the line at first, but a foul ball, 1-1. From the belt, kicks and deals. 1-2.
Not likely to see a fourth fastball in this situation. I'm going to eliminate the fastball if I'm at the plate right here.
Runner on first with two away. To 2 balls and 2 strikes now.
Hey, they tried to tie him up on that last pitch, so I like that they went away with this one. The execution didn't work, but I like the idea behind it.
And then misses there, so he runs the count full now.
Well, this has been a good at bat. He's now worked the count full to 3-2. It allows the runner on first to be on the move with two away.
And he struck him out. His 8th punch out of the ballgame, and that one ends the inning. So no runs here, no base hits, no errors, and a runner left. Top of the order due up in the home half of the 6th. It's the Angels 1 and the Phillies nothing. So the batting order turns over now and set to go. Gene Segura to start things out in the 6th for a lineup that really hasn't found its groove in this one.
Yeah, only 2 hits so far, Matt, and not very many target balls either. We'll see if they can start making some adjustments.
First delivery to him on the way. Fastball a bit too low here. It's 1-1. Trying to bunt his way aboard, but he can't connect, and it's 1-1. Now here it comes. A ball and 2 strikes now.
1-2.
That's how you open up the outside part of the plate. Count 2 balls in, and they get right back outside. Nice pitch.
Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Looking to send him packing again. Gregorius with a sliding stop. The throw. Got him. And what a vital play there, preventing the leadoff man from getting aboard.
Now batted. Third baseman. Justin.
Now batting, Justin Turner. He's 0-2 thus far in this one. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. No balls and a strike to count. Bases are empty. One man out. Ball one. And it's 1-1.
I got a ball, one strike.
This is on the ground over the first. And cleanly. And for the bag himself to the out.
The center fielder, number 24. Withenshaw.
Ready once again, Mark Withenshaw. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, and he didn't put up much of a fight either, Matt. He got to find a way. Can't go down three pitches. I don't care if you're staring at him or swinging at him. You have to find a way to make this pitcher work a little bit harder.
Hey, this guy's got to be pretty proud of what he's done so far. It's never easy to pitch on the road, but to have this kind of outing in a ballpark that is notoriously known as being hitter-friendly, it's been a treat to watch.
Wind up and the 0-1. Swing and a line drive. And that finds the outfield grass for a base hit. He'll get it into second. And he is safe at second base as he legs out a double. Finally, a little something for them to get excited about.
Yeah, a rally can begin with a single swing of the bat. This might be their chance right here. They've struggled to produce a lot of runs, but there he is at second base. A shot to the outfield scores. Then who knows what kind of roll they can get on. Got to take it one good at-bat at a time.
And Bryce Harper will dig into the plate as he'll take a look at a strike on the outside corner. It's 0-1.
Hey, this isn't exactly the way you'd like to draw it up. Not throwing a lot of first pitch strikes, but the bottom line is he's getting outs.
Comes set, the 0-1. Two out here and running at second. One and two now.
One ball, two strikes, count.
Look out. That one almost got away from him. Two and two now.
Boy, that's a good pitch right there. The old school guys would call that a little bit of chin music up and in. See if he can get him to move off the box a little bit.
The 2-2 pitch. And he hammers it to deep right field. But it bangs off the out-of-town scoreboard. Second now, but he's safe as a run comes across to score on the play, tying the ball game.
Man, it's like deja vu all over again. Two well-hit back-to-back doubles that bring in a run. This one ends up going off the wall, and it looks like they've got a pretty good idea what this guy's trying to do to them out there. Definitely getting some good swings against him.
Bring up the Sacramento product, Reese Hoskins. Ball one to start the at bat. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. And he gets a piece of this one to foul it toward the backstop. And that's high off the plate, 2-1.
Man, this guy's had their number all game long. Up, down, in and out. He's pitching very well.
And it's two balls and two strikes now.
And it's out 2-2.
Lifted out towards straightaway center field. Trout has a read on it, hauls it in, and the potential go-ahead run will not come around to score. One for the Phillies here on the RBI double. Bottom third of the order, 7-8-9, due up to start the seventh, all tied at 1-1. Medina is on the pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven.
For the Phillies, number 77.
Box, Mark Canna. They'll go to work trying to do something about breaking this 1-1 tie. First pitch of the at-bat. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike.
That's the exact spot to lean on as a reliever. As a hitter, you just have to tip your cap and look for the next one.
pitch on its way. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone. To third. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number seven.
Now batting, the catcher, Jason Castro.
Sliding into the box, Jason Castro. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point. First offering on its way.
Off the plate, ball one.
The 1-0.
Outside.
Couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat, trying to get ahead and put himself in a good hitter's count.
2-0 count, the pitch. Giving chase. He can't get there as it falls in.
The pitcher, number 17, Johei.
David Fletcher come on to pinch hit here in a big spot.
Number 7, David Fletcher.
Hit hard down the left field line, but this is going to get fouled. Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. One and one. From the stretch. Fastball in there for a cold strike.
Well, the Angels have been searching for that big hit pretty much all game. It remains to be seen if they can get it, but now sure will be a great time.
Here comes the 0-1. Strike swinging, timing a little off on that one.
Big pitch coming up right here. He'd love for a ground ball or strikeout.
He struck him out, and a big out there as the go-ahead run stays at third with two gone now.
It's so hard to hit when you're behind the count 0-2, right? You have to protect the fastball. You have to look for the soft stuff down and away. You're really at a disadvantage when you fall behind 0-2.
Standing in now, Brian Goodwin. He'll take a look at a strike right down the middle. It's 0-1. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point.
at the ball.
As one that misses high, it's 1-1. Here it is.
Oh, that's out.
A time to start making some quality pitches. He finds himself in a tough spot behind an account with guys on base.
Ball three.
Falling behind now, 3-1.
I got 3-1.
Couldn't be a whole lot better situation to hit in now. 3-1, 2 on. He's got to be thinking he's going to get a pitch he can drive right here.
Three and one, here it is. And he misses with it for ball four. So the bases will be loaded now with two away.
That's a big no-no. He obviously had to work carefully with two men on, but he did not want to walk and load the bases. Now he's really got his work cut out for him. We'll see how he fares here.
And that'll bring Mike Trout to the dish. It was a walk in his last trip. Looking to wiggle out of this, here it is.
Second inning. You want to show up when the game is on the line. Can you quiet your emotions down, take the crowd out of it, and slow yourself down enough to come through? And that's exactly what he did.
Zach Eflin answers the call to pitch here in a big spot. He inherits a bases loaded jam but needs just one out to get out of it. So here's the cleanup pitch. Anthony Rendon. Been a rough go of things at the plate for him so far, but these guys are looking for him to change that right here.
Yeah, nothing better than coming through from the boys in a tight game, man. Especially when you're kind of due to do something productive.
Looking to keep this a one-run game.
Nope,
the pitch.
The ball.
The 2-2. Got him. So the damage winds up not being as bad as it could have been as they'll strand the bases loaded. This side is good. The Angels get just the one. Seventh inning stretch time here at the ballpark. The Halos lead this one 2-1. Noah Ramirez gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh. Stepping in, Jay Bruce, third trip to the plate for him here tonight. 0-for-2 at this point.
This thing's far from over, even though we're moving into the back end of this game. Only down by one. All they need to do is get this leadoff guy, and they're an extra base hit away from tying this thing up.
From the stretch, here's the pitch. Hits the bottom of the strike zone here with a sinker. Strike one. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up.
Breaking ball called just a good look.
Don't be shocked if he doesn't go right back to that same pitch. You could tell he jelly-legged him at the plate a little bit. Froze him, but just missed his own.
Here's a little chopper up the middle. He's got it. And there's one down now.
Up next for Philadelphia, the catcher, Zach Collins.
Into the box now, Zach Collins. First pitch of the at-bat on its way.
Ooh, I'm shocked he got away with that one, boys. Curveball right down the middle of the plate. And for him to take that pitch looking, he had to be sitting on something else, but he should have pulled the trigger.
And here's a curveball in the dirt that time for a ball. 1-1. Ground ball right side, straight into the shift. There is La Stella, and there's out number two.
Now back, double base hit. Mosier.
Stepping into the box, Logan Forsythe. Delivery to him on the way.
Ball that jumps out.
One and oh delivery. Right side. That is through into right field for a single.
Hey, guys, he doubled up on that breaking ball. The batter obviously timed the first one. The second one, he was not going to let go. Good wood on that one, able to drive it for a base hit.
Corey Dickerson will grab a bat hit for the pitcher.
Number 12, Corey Dickerson.
Pitch curveball runs in a bit too tight. It's ball one.
Hey, I know the tying runs at first right here, but if the pitcher on the mound executes, keeps the ball in play, I think good things are going to happen.
And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
I don't blame him for not coming over the heart of the plate. He circled this guy on the lineup card when he got to the yard today. He's been swinging one of the hotter bats in the game.
Two-oh count, pitch outside. 3-0 now.
Yeah, it looked like he was going to cruise through this inning, but now a hit. A 3-0 count have changed that. Got to get back in the strike zone right here.
From the stretch. We're in the seventh inning now of a pitcher's duel. 2-1 our score. And I believe they'll say he broke the plane, as yes, he did. It's ruled a strike. Now the payoff pitch home. Gets him looking at the knees for the strikeout. One left for Philadelphia. They're down 2-1. Mike Warren has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 28, Mike Warren.
Ready to begin the eighth, and that will bring up Didi Gregorius.
Didi Gregorius.
Here comes the first pitch.
This one's outside. Quite a bit off the plate that time. Morin was known as a short relief specialist, a guy who came in, got one or two big outs, but with the new pace of play rules, they're forcing a change for this right-hander.
And the throw pulls the first baseman off the bag, and he's safe at first. And this will go down as an E5, as you can see the exasperation on his face. Digging in, Tommy La Stella sat down on strikes in his last at-bat. Swings and misses. Throw down. It skips in and he's safe.
He's safe.
Close play, but he's in there. No one out with a runner at second. One and one to Tommy La Stella. Called strike and he's behind one and two.
Strikeout and never threw the same pitch twice in a row, and he won the battle because of it.
So now it's Mark Pena as the first pitch to him is taken low and away for ball one. The 1-0.
I don't mind him trying to pitch him backwards right there with those two early count sliders. And now he finds himself in a situation where he's going to have to come fastball.
Now the 2-0. Hard hit to first. And he'll take this one back for the out. But meanwhile, the runner will move up 90 feet to third base.
Back for the injury. The catcher, Jason Castro.
Digging in and looking for more, Jason Castro. He singled his last time up. First offering on its way. There's a slider to start things out, looked at for ball one. According to the career numbers on the back of his baseball card, Castro is slugging a little under the 400 mark, so the chances of his connecting with the ball right here aren't particularly good. Two balls and a strike. Early swing there as he pulls it foul to the right side. And two. Here it is.
When a pitch is close to working through a quick inning, that's when you really need to grind out some at-bats. He's done a good job of that, and that's really big when you're hitting towards the bottom of the order.
Ready with the payoff pitch. Got him. And he goes down on strikes for the third time. Angels lead one. They still lead it 2-1. At the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Bedrosian come on to pitch now. He'll move into the eighth spot in the lineup on the double switch here. Max Stassi will also come on now. He'll move into the pitcher's number nine hole in the order here on that double switch. Digging in, Shin Segura. He was a ground out victim last time up. Ready to to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now. Nothing in two count and pitch. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Goodwin is right there. One down. Next to the plate for the Phillies, Justin Turner.
He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. Here's the first pitch to him. The pitcher's duel continues here. 2-1 score as we play the eighth.
Swing and a deep drive to left, and it ain't coming back. That one is out of here. This game is tied. A solo shot here to left, and we are tied again. Swing, but he went around for the first strike. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Oh, 1, here's the pitch.
Inside, ball one.
And that one got a piece of him.
I got him. Take your break.
Well, he might be feeling a little bit of a sting there, but he can take comfort in knowing that he represents the go-ahead run. That could turn out to be a huge hit by Pitch.
And that one will be the cleanup spot for the Phillies. Bryce Harper has got a hit in 3 at-bats to this point. First delivery to him on the way. Went about halfway there, but it's a called strike regardless.
Can't come out of this game plan right here. He knows he's a known sinker baller. I know it was a four-seamer right there, but get back to that two-seam. It's what his MO is.
Here's the 0-1. Weak grounder down the first baseline. But that'll get foul. It's 0-2 now. Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. For the delivery, a check on that go-ahead run at first. And again a throw, keeping particularly close tabs on it. Tried to get him to go after one below the knees, but it's 1-2.
Those were two great executed pitches right there away from this batter. He can hurt you in a heartbeat. I don't think anything's going to leak out over the heart of the plate.
Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away.
He lays off it to even the count 2-2.
Looks like this guy's afraid to throw the ball to the strike zone. Gave up that home run earlier in the inning. Needs to get back to being aggressive.
Pitch inside, the throw. And it's going to be far too late. That's a stolen base. Go-ahead runs in scoring position here with one away. Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away.
That was a big strikeout there, guys. The best pitchers have the ability to strike guys out when they really need to. And that second out was really important at this point of the game. Could be something we look back on later when the game's over.
Next to bat will be Rhys Hoskins. As he looks at a fastball that misses off the plate for ball one. A runner in scoring position with two now. Ready with the 1-0.
That's a tough call for Blue right there. Either way you call it, somebody doesn't like it. But hey, that's the life of an umpire.
Swing and a miss on the heater. It's 2-1. Go ahead runs in scoring position here with two down. Fouled off.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
A payoff pitch. Side, but it's going to be a foul ball. Go ahead runs in scoring position here with two down. And another foul ball. Away.
Hey, have an AB right here. I know it's frustrating the heck out of the pitcher. You keep fouling these pitchers off, maybe one misses over the heart of the plate.
A swing by Hoskins, and this is driven to deep left. Looking up is Goodwin. It's gone. They've taken the lead in the eighth. Shot to straightaway left. They've taken a two-run lead. So far. On its way, the 0-1 pitch. And boy, big problems here to start this at bat. It's 0-2 now.
Usually you see chases outside the zone on off-speed stuff like sliders, breaking balls, and changeups. but to chase a fastball that far outside the zone tells me this hitter's not seeing it well at all.
To a 1-2 now. And two strikes now.
Don't be surprised if he gets another back foot slider right here. Don't think for a second just because he took the first one that this pitcher won't come back exactly the same way.
Three runs already home here. Fastball well off the plate for a ball.
I'd say this is a win already for the guy in the box. You find yourself down 0-2, you work it to even, and now it's full. You got a chance to do some damage in this situation.
Crowd gets up for the 3-2. Swing and a long drive again. This one to deep center. And it's out of here.
Good pitch around the knees, but it doesn't quite catch the bottom of the zone.
But this one almost in books. The story was clearly the long ball. What are your thoughts on this offense, fellas?
Well, Matty V, I don't know what your thoughts are, D-Roll, but boy, when the weather starts to warm up and the ball starts jumping out like this, it's clear that the pitchers need to start making better pitches.
Yeah, just great approach. No one really chased today. Really stayed staunch on their ability to get that pitcher to come into the heart of the plate, and they did damage with it.
Two and two.
I got to count. Two and two.
I think it's about time to choke up on that bat and get that foot down. He's awfully tardy right now.
Forsythe with a full 3-2 count.
That was kind of a gift to the hitter. He's up there probably thinking of protecting on 2-2, but when you launch a ball that high out of the strike zone, it's obviously easy to take that one.
Fastball too high. Ball four.
What's the saying? When you find yourself in a hole, the first thing you should do is stop digging. Well, the guy on the bump obviously hasn't heard that one.
Felix Pena enters here looking to get the final out before the ninth inning.
Number 54, Felix Pena.
Scott Kingery will look for some two-out magic here as he'll pinch hit with two gone and a runner at first.
Kingery.
close there, but he doesn't get the call with the breaking ball. And he's got that batting lineup near the 300 mark entering play. Hit the other way out toward right field. Chasing after it is Maven. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning. So a very good outburst here as five runs come across and allow them to take the lead. We've played eight full. It's the Phillies six and the Angels two. Morgan Rodriguez comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth. Set to start the ninth in this one. And the catcher Max Stassi will be the next to bat. Here's the first pitch to him. Ninth inning underway now as the first pitch is taken for a called strike. Pitch on its way.
And think about it. In game one of this series, they've already had to go deep into their bullpen. This could affect them for the rest of the weekend if they don't get really good starting pitching.
The 1-1.
That's outside.
Good job to work the count, put himself back in the driver's seat. Started off with one strike, and now he's got the count in his favor, 3-1.
And this pitch misses here. It's ball four, and they've got a leadoff base runner aboard to start the ninth.
And that hole at bat, I feel like you really didn't want to challenge him. And I'm really surprised by that, because I think this is a guy in the bottom third of the order you have to go right after.
Coming to the plate now, Cameron Maven. He's set. Here it comes. Hit high and deep out to straightaway left. Bruce looking up, and this ball is gone. No chance to make a play on that one. It's a two-run shot to straightaway left, number 14 on the season, and they cut the gap here. It's now 6-4.
Hitters today have become such great low ball hitters. That's case in point right there. You see him using his lower half to create and get his bat on plane and elevate that low heat.
Now batting.
To the plate now, Brian Goodwin. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. He's hitless in three at bats to this point. A 2-0 count to the Angels left fielder.
This inning really feels like it's getting away from him out there. As a reliever, you can't let that happen. Nothing you can do about what's already happened, and it's only going to get worse if you're not focusing on the guy in the batter's box.
The 2-0. A swing and a miss. That's the first strike. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. The 2-1. It's laid off of for ball number three.
It's clear he just hasn't been able to find any rhythm out there. Pretty much unable to hit any of his spots. And now he's at 3-1, and he's put him into another great hitting count.
This is in the air out to straightaway center. Rhythm shot. Right there, one down.
The center fielder, number 27, Mike Trout.
David Robertson answers the call from the dugout as he'll try to record the final two outs of this one.
the center fielder Mike Trout. He's looking for hit number three here in this at bat. Set and the pitch. High and deep down the left field line. And this is going to wind up a foul ball. Ready with the nothing in one pitch. And he powers the cut fastball by him that time, and he's in charge now, nothing in two. Still only one out in the inning. Swing and a miss. He offered it a ball way outside the strike zone for out number two.
I think he had his mind made up. He was swinging the bat and trying to protect before the ball even left the pitcher's hand. That pitch wasn't even close. He would have needed a flagpole to get that one.
Into the box now, Anthony Rendon. As he'll watch one miss down and in for a ball, 1-0. Struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here. Count. Here it is. Bases are empty here with two men out. And there's ball three. Ball here misses down and in, ball four.
That is just a great at bat there. When you're down late, any base runners, any way you can get them, and that never say die mentality could be the difference. We'll see how it plays out.
And now for the Angels,
Didi Gregorius.
Lifetime numbers versus David Robertson. He's 1-for-3. First pitch on its way. Out with the man at first. Now a swing and he pops him up, and this should do it. And make the final out to put an end to this one, and the Phillies taking the opener here at home. And this ball game is over.
Always nice to get the first game of the series, but even more so when it's in front of the home crowd. Seems to energize everybody the rest of the series.
A 6-4 finish in tonight's affair. Philadelphia used a huge eighth inning to help secure the win. Mike Morin earns the victory out of the bullpen, his fifth. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter at MLB The Show.